Hello and welcome everyone. Today we are going to learn the next part of a parts of speech conjunction. I have already discussed each and every detail about a noun, pronoun, a verb, an adverb, and an adjective. If you haven't seen yet, go to the description. I have given a link for all these lessons. So, in this lesson, we will learn what is a conjunction. We will also learn different types of conjunctions with examples. Download the PDF given a link in the description of some question and answers related to this lesson. Try to do all without seeing the answers and check how many of them you have answered correctly. Let's start with the definition. A conjunction is a word that joins two or more words, phrases, clauses, or even sentences. And, but, for, or, yet, because, after, all these are called conjunctions. Look at the first example. The students got bored, so they went to the playground. Here, so is a conjunction and it is used to combine or join two clauses. The students got bored is one clause and they went to the playground is another clause. And both are called independent clauses. Now, if you ask me, what is an independent clause? Remember, an independent clause makes sense on its own. It doesn't depend on any other clause. Click on the I button to learn more details about a clause and its types. In the second example, she bought a pencil and a sharpener. And is a conjunction. And it joins two words here, a pencil and a sharpener. Now move on to the types of conjunctions. Mainly, there are three types of conjunctions: coordinating conjunctions, subordinating conjunctions, and correlative conjunctions. Let me explain the first type of conjunction, coordinating conjunction. This is the most common type of conjunction. Coordinating conjunctions are used to join words, phrases, or independent clauses that are of a similar type in a sentence. Coordinating conjunctions are limited and they are only 7 words: for, and, nor, but, or, yet, so. You can easily remember all the 7 words with a simple acronym, Fanboys. In the first example, I like coffee, but my brother prefers tea. Here, a coordinating conjunction but joins two independent clauses. I like coffee and my brother prefers tea. When a coordinating conjunction joining two independent clauses plus a comma before the conjunction. In the second example, Roy and Tom are good dancers. Here, the coordinating conjunction is and it connects two noun words, Roy and Tom. Is there any comma in this example? No, because when a coordinating conjunction joins two words or phrases, do not use a comma. Now move on to the second type of conjunction, subordinating conjunction. Subordinating conjunctions are used to join subordinate or dependent clauses to independent or main clauses. Means subordinating conjunctions join two unequal parts. After, as, although, before, because, if, how, and many more are called subordinating conjunctions. Look at the first example. I will buy you a new motorbike if you pass the exam. Here, if you pass the exam is a dependent clause starting with a subordinating conjunction if, and I will buy you a new motorbike is an independent clause. Remember, a comma is often not necessary if a subordinating conjunction follows an independent clause. But if I interchange the two clauses, like in second example, if you pass the exam, I will buy you a new motorbike. This sentence is started with a dependent clause, if you pass the exam. Remember, if a dependent clause comes first in a sentence, it needs to be followed by a comma. Now, the third and last type of conjunction, correlative conjunction. Correlative conjunctions are used to join equal sentence elements together. Remember, correlative conjunctions are always used in pairs, like either or, neither nor, both and, not only but also, whether or, so that, as, so as, no sooner than. First example, either Anuj or Manoj will come online today. Either or is a correlative conjunction and it indicates that there are two possibilities, Anuj or Manoj. In the second example, I like neither John nor David. Neither nor clearly shows that it is the negative form of either or, and it is the correlative conjunction here. Now, here are some more examples for you to identify the types of conjunctions. So, let's know the answers. In the third example, this movie is suitable for both children and adults. Both and is a conjunction and it is a correlative conjunction. In fourth and fifth example, Alan is not so dull as the principal expected. He speaks not only French but also German. So as and not only but also are also correlative conjunctions. But in the last example, Sneha is absent in the class because she is ill. Here the conjunction is because and it is a subordinating conjunction. Well, that's all for this session. Please make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get all the notifications of my latest videos. Keep practicing and improve your English skills. Thank you so much for joining me for this lesson. I will see you very soon in my next lesson.